Dear students, now let us study about measurement. Students, there are many substances around us. These substances can be measured. For measuring, we use units. The length of a piece of cloth, weight of some potatoes, amount of oil, and so forth are the commonest examples that we measure in our daily life. While solving numerical problems in mathematics, you use a ruler to measure length of a line or a segment. Similarly, for measuring time, we use clock, isn't it? Students, these quantities that we can measure are called physical quantities. Since long time, people have been using some methods for measuring different quantities. For measuring mass, they used pan balance. In early time, people used hand or a long stick to measure length. Early units of measurement were miles, feet, inches, seconds, and so forth. Students, the scientists thought of using some standard quantities for measuring a substance. They used units of measurement for measuring various physical quantities. All physical quantities can be broadly divided into fundamental quantities and derived quantities. Students, mass, length, time, and so forth are fundamental quantities. They are independent quantities from which other quantities can be obtained. A unit of fundamental quantity is known as a fundamental unit. Kilogram, meter, second are the examples of fundamental unit. The examples of fundamental unit and are the units of mass, length, and time respectively. Students, velocity is a derived quantity. It is derived from two fundamental quantities such as displacement and time. Acceleration, pressure, force, and so forth are some other examples of derived quantities. A unit of derived quantity is known as derived unit, like meter per second, meter per second square, and so forth are the examples of derived unit, and they are the units of velocity and acceleration respectively.